Hi everyone, so today we're going to get up close and personal. You guys really liked the last time that I did one of those videos. I will link it up here in the corner for you. And in that video, I shared with you like my everyday makeup routine and what it truly really looked like on the skin. And I thought this format of video also lends itself really nicely to new in things, because then I can share with you my review and I can show you close up on the skin how things sit and how things look and kind of give you the reason for my feedback, my critiques, why I like it, why I don't. So this video is a bit of a 3-in-1. It's sort of a semi-haul. A few of these things I've been sent, but most I have purchased. All of that stuff is always in the description box, as always. I've been using them over the last couple of weeks just to give them a go, test them out, try different techniques, like work out what I think are the gems of these bits, what I would recommend repurchase again, and then the few things that I like can't really work out. And then it's a bit of a tutorial because I'm going to throw them on my face at the same time. So let's kick things off. Let's zoom. Always do this the wrong way. Oh, there you go, the right way this time. Well, okay, is that close enough for you? So I was looking for a new primer. I obviously like things to look very juicy, very dewy on the skin, and I found this. This is from Estee Lauder and it's their Futurist Aqua Brilliance Watery Glow Primer. Looks a little something like this. And after giving this product a go, I quite like it. It comes out in like a gel cream format. And when you start applying it on the skin, it does go really watery and thin. And I feel like it gives glow to the skin whilst feeling more like a skincare product, really. There's no detectable shimmer or anything like that in it, which personally I really like. As always with primers, my skin heats up a bit and has a bit of a moment, but like 2 minutes later, it'll look completely fine. There you go. It's calming down already. Overall, I really like this product. I feel like it's a good option for people who find things like the Glossier Halo Scope too intense. I love Glossier Halo Scope, but it almost leaves not a grease on the skin, but it gives a detectable kind of tacky finish on the skin, a real glow that almost sits on the skin, whereas I feel like this is more skincare. It sinks into the skin a little bit more. I feel like I've got radiance, I feel like I've got glow, but it's not as intense as other things that I've used in this category. So a good option if perhaps you're more normal to sort of oily and you want that glow, but you don't want that feeling of glow on your skin. I'm personally quite dry, so I love something like the Glossier. Halo Scope for me is perfection, chef's kiss. But I think this would be a good option for the summer if I'm a little bit more sweaty and I don't want something that is so heavy and as like obvious on the skin. Next up is something that loads of you have asked that I review, and it is the IT Cosmetics Your Skin But Better Foundation Plus Skincare Waterlight Medium Coverage Natural Radiant Finish. And I have this in the shade Light Warm 21, which is quite a good dupe for their fair shade that I use, and then Light Warm 23, which is a good dupe for the light shade that I use. Today I'm going to use Light Warm 23 because I went a little bit OTT with my self-tanner drops last night. So for me, the CC cream in this range has been banished. There aren't enough shades in it. The spread of shades just isn't diverse enough. Actually, I'm going to go for a pump of each. I feel like maybe the Light Warm 23 might be a bit intense on its own. I don't think that would be the best shade match for me right now. But the great news with this foundation is that it's been released in a ton of shades, and it feels like they've really tried to put the work in when it comes to the spread of those shades as well. I think there's about either 40 or 42 shades in total. And if you go on their website, I found a really easy chart to work out, if you've used a CC cream, what your shade match would be in this foundation. So I'll link that down below for you because I was finding it a bit difficult to match myself online. The idea with this foundation is that it's more of a medium coverage, whereas a CC cream they say is more of a light to medium coverage. Personally, I would say it's more of a medium coverage for CC cream, and this is more of a medium to full coverage, and it's supposed to have added skincare benefits as well as being a foundation at the same time. Now, I had high hopes for this foundation. I'm a big fan of the CC cream minus the shade range debacle, but I don't know how I feel about this. I think it's because I'm wearing a lot lighter bases these days, and so something that feels so foundation-y feels a little bit stark when I put it on. I'm like looking in the viewfinder here and thinking, wow, that's a lot of makeup. Personally, I find it easiest to use with a brush. I find that it's just too thick to apply with fingers. I don't really use a makeup sponge these days, so brush all the way. And I do find, exactly the same as Lily actually, you have to work quite quickly with this. I sort of dab it on and then go really quick all over the face. I feel like it can dry down quite quickly. I'm going to zoom you in a little bit further just so hopefully you can see what I mean about this foundation. Hopefully I'm still in focus, but I feel that it clings a little bit in my dry areas. Like when I look at it close up here, it kind of sits on the skin. Well, okay, that's really close. I'm not sure if that's showing up. So for me, it almost clings to those areas of dryness, but then it also sits on top of the skin at the same time. I don't feel like it really melts into my skin and completely blends away. I feel like it's just too detectable sitting on top of the skin. I feel like I can really see it on top of my skin. And this is when it's first applied and throughout the day. I feel like that, I know Alana calls it curdling sometimes. I feel like that curdling gets even more pronounced and even worse throughout the day. So for me, it's not the worst foundation I've tried, but it's not the best either. I don't think it is one that I would reach for all that often. It's just a little bit too dry and I'm not crazy about the blendability of it. I feel like I've got things that look far more natural on the skin. I'm really obsessed with the Makeup Forever Reboot foundation at the moment and also the Giorgio Armani Neo Nude, both of which completely just melt into your skin. It doesn't look like you're wearing makeup at all. So I feel like this is looking great on camera right now, but in person, it looks a little too heavy for me. Okay, I couldn't find a new concealer, so I'm just gonna go back in with the RMS Uncover Up. I'm getting there, guys. I'm getting there. This is the shade 11. I'm just gonna pop that under my eyes and around my nose. BRB. Now, this product isn't new, but it's definitely new to me, and it's the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Bronzer. This is available in 4 different shades, and I am using 2 medium at the moment. Looks a little something like this. Now, I haven't used a powder bronzer probably for like at least a year. I was really obsessed with the Chanel and then more recently the Fenty Beauty cream bronzer. I just love a cream product. But this is a really nice powder bronzer. I really like it. It's very sheer, really nice and easy to build up. It's not patchy at all. I really like the tone of the medium. I think the tone is really beautiful and warming on the skin. Gotta get those ears. I like that it comes with refills as well. Definitely not as wasteful because obviously the compact is huge. You get a shed load of product in here as well. 16 grams. 16 grams. Doesn't sound like a lot, does it? But it is in makeup terms. So yeah, I really like that. I just think it's nice, sheer, easy to build up. Comes in 4 different shades. Have I said that already? Yes. Just a nice solid product, a nice matte bronzer. There's no detectable shimmer in this. It's just soft on the skin. Really nice all-rounder product. I feel like if you're into more minimal looks or if you're into more of a glam look, you would like this either way. Now for a highlighter, I was sent some of the Honest Beauty products they've recently released here in the UK. They're available on Cult Beauty and it's Jessica Alba's beauty and lifestyle brand. You've probably heard about it for years but not been able to get your hands on it. I know I certainly have, and this is the Honest Beauty Magic Beauty Balm Stick. And it's my favorite type of highlighter. You guys know that I love a stick. What one did I bring with me to mum and dad's? Oh, I bought the Becca Glow Glaze Stick. Still working my way through this. I feel like they're the easiest to apply. I feel like they look the most natural. I think this just comes in the one shade, or we can only get one shade here in the UK. It reminds me a lot of the Glossier one in Quartz. It's a little bit golden, a little bit champagne-y, a little bit pinky. My first reaction when I used this was that it feels a bit gritty in my fingers. So I've just applied the product there to my fingers and then I'm just gonna blend that onto my cheeks. Please ignore the pale hands. I've gone way too much with the bronzer here, but you know, holding on to those summer vibes. I don't know if you can see it there on the cheeks. I like it. I feel like it is very, very subtle and I'm not crazy about the texture of it, the feeling of it between my fingers. I don't like that it's got that grit in there, that slight shimmer in there. I personally much prefer something like the Becca Glow Glaze Stick or the Glossier Halo Scope or the Chanel Balms that they have. All beautiful and all feel much more like a refined texture almost. I feel like the texture of this makes me think the product is cheap and it's not that cheap. I think it's around a similar price point to Glossier Halo Scope. It's not called Halo Scope, is it? Yes, it is. I always get confused between Future Dew and Holoscope. It is called Glossier Holoscope. I would personally rather pick that. I just think the texture is a nicer texture. So it's a bit like the IT Cosmetics. It's not the worst product I've tried, but it's not the best either. And I have other things I would personally prefer to use. Okay, on to something that is utterly, utterly fab and I adore. It's from Fenty Beauty and it's the Brow MVP Sculpting Brow Wax Pencil and Styler. I've used the hell out of this already. So on one side, you've got this brow wax. And then on the other side, it looks like a toothbrush, but it's just a little brow comb. Ignore how dirty mine is already, please. This is such a brilliant product. It's the closest I've found to finding soap brows, but without having to do soap brows, which can ultimately just be a bit of a faff. This is so much easier to use. I would say when my brows weren't trimmed, so pre going to see my lovely brow lady, Claire, Perfect Brow Brighton, I adore her. It definitely didn't hold them up because they were too weighty. My brows were actually just too heavy. But once she trimmed them and she'd worked her magic on them, I came home, used this, and I was absolutely wowed. So my one tip would be you don't need a lot of this brow wax. One swipe through is all you need. If you put any more in, it can start looking a bit heavy and you can get chunks of the wax in your brows. But there you go. It's fabulous. I absolutely love it. So this is after, this is before. Let me do this one here for you. And then just combing them upwards. Like, what? Wow. I would say this is probably my favorite product that I'm going to share with you today. I have worn this every single day. Even if I'm not having a makeup wearing day, I will still put this through my brows because it just makes all the difference. Obviously, sometimes you might put a jumper on or something and it might mess it up. I just go through with this or a brow spoolie and pop them back into place. Or if I haven't got that, kind of smooth them back into place with my fingers and it just sets them down. One of the best products that I have used this year. Definitely my favorite of everything I'm going to share with you today. Love, love, love it. I forgot to share with you the finished complexion, just so you can see that a little closer up. I mean, it looks quite nice on the camera, but it does gather in these areas around the nose and also around the chin. I feel like it looks a bit uneven. You can almost see how it's worn off here in the middle. I didn't put any heavy concealer on my spots today, just so you can kind of see the coverage of the IT Cosmetics. I mean, it looks nice on camera. I just don't think the wear is there and the finish is up to scratch compared to my favorites. The next thing I've been giving a test is from NARS and it comes in the most beautiful packaging. It's the Extreme Effects eyeshadow palette. Absolutely beautiful. Now, for someone like me who wears basically a sticky brown shade on their eyes every single day that I'm wearing makeup, I would say that this palette is quite a stretch for me. This is definitely an evening, festive, wintry palette for me. I like the shades in this, but it's definitely not my everyday palette. The Afterglow palette, I adore from NARS. The Wanted palette, I think, was beautiful as well. And just like those, I feel like the texture of these is beautiful. I was reading on the website, they're super matte shimmers and then kind of pressed glitters. And they're supposed to have this almost latexy feel to them. And I was like, yes, when I've been swatching them, when I've been using them, they're almost a bit, not watercolory, that makes them sound wishy-washy, but they are so soft. They're really, really soft, which personally, I really enjoy because I feel like it makes them easy to use. It's not too much pigment or too much color on your eye in one go. It makes them soft and easy to blend. So I'm super, super into that. And I like that some of these shades that personally I would think absolutely no way would I ever wear this, like this purple, is actually one of my favorites. Let me swatch this for you. This is more of a glitter that's beautiful and soft. It's got this like burgundy base with this pink lilac-y monochrome. Very Katie Jane Hughes. So if you're looking to extend yourself a little bit, I'd say this palette is a really good option. Or if this sort of color story is your everyday go-to, I don't think you can go wrong with this. For me, it's definitely not a must-have like the Afterglow palette, which I just absolutely adore. But it definitely matches previous palettes in terms of texture and ease of use. I think today I'm gonna go for this pink and just do like a pink flamingo-y eye. Flamingo-y. So I'm just taking that pink just all over on a fluffy brush and blending that out. I feel like they blend just really smooth. They're very smooth shadows. I mean, that literally took me 30 seconds. My favorite kind of eye look. I really love that color. Feels like it's a bit different to my usual orange shades that I use, but still very much within my comfort zone. So overall, a really gorgeous palette, definitely up there with the usual high quality of NARS eyeshadows, but just one to go for. If you want to push the boat out a little bit, if you want to add something a little bit different to your neutral color story, for me, definitely more of a going out palette. This red though. Right, I couldn't find any new waterproof mascaras, so I'm gonna throw some of that on and then come back and chat to you about lips. Okay, I've got two new launches here. One of them is the Ilia Balmy Gloss Tinted Lip Oil. This is in the shade Petals. I picked this up from Space NK. It's really nice. It's quite like the Rowan Liquid Lip Balm. This is in the shade Remy. I really, really like this lip product. This is kind of the lip product that I just reach for every day. But this one is obviously a lot brighter, a lot more pinky. It has a bit more shine to it than the Rowan. The Rowan does actually feel like a balm. This has a little bit more of a glossy texture. I'll come close and throw it on. So you can see, that's pretty glossy. That's pretty pink. I would say it's maybe a bit too pink for me. Like, you know me, I like to do a bit of dabbing. Once I've basically dabbed the whole matte product away, then I like it. I think this is a really nice product. It's just that for me, it's perhaps a little too juicy on the lips. But another thing that I'm really, really enjoying are these. These are from Clarins and they are the Velvet Lip Perfectors. I was sent these and I kept the shade 01, which is a nude, and then 03, which is a raspberry red. I thought it'd be nice to kind of try one of each. And I really like the nude shade. So these are like the Instant Light Lip Perfectors. They are such a gorgeous gloss texture. It's my mum's favorite lip product. They're a bestseller, like cult classic for a reason. But these are the same sort of applicator. So you've got the sponge tip on top, but they just deposit a more kind of almost satiny velvet stain on the lips. These are almost the minimalist version of a liquid lipstick, which personally, I haven't worn a liquid lipstick in years. I find them way, way, way too heavy and like cracky on my lips. Does that make any sense? These are the Glossier version of that almost. I'll put it on now. How nice is that? Just a very soft look on the lips. Nothing too heavy. It's almost like your lips are just naturally this color. So very, very into this launch. Would love to see Clarins come out with more shades than this. So there you have it, a full face of Nguyen beauty products. Some I love, some I'm not the biggest fan of, but hopefully you've been able to see them close up and sort of see my reasoning behind it a little bit more. Let me know if you like this video, let me know if there's anything else you would like me to try, or if you'd like me to do a close-up video around another theme. I'm all ears, I love filming these. I love getting close up and personal. Everything will be linked down in the description box as always. And yeah, cheers guys. I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.